Hey guys, it's Frenzy, and it's near the end of 2011, and I'm going to do some collection videos for the year. It is December 22nd, actually, and this is my folding knife collection. One of my favorite knife manufacturers is Emerson, and over the years I have bought quite a number of them, and I'll go ahead and review those very quickly. Up here at the top, we've got a Gentleman Jim. It's the Emerson's version of a Gentleman knife. 3.75 inch blade, not too heavy, and considerably narrower across this direction than most of the other Emersons. Nice knife if that's what you're looking for. This is a CQC 10. I believe it's like a 3.6 inch blade. When I first bought it was one of my first Emersons. I thought I'd love it because of the Spidey style hole, and I haven't, and I don't. It's not one of my favorites. I don't carry it that much at all. What we've got down here is the Roadhouse. Great knife. It's 3.8 or 3.9, I forget. Most of their big ones are in that range. Really nice tanto knife if you're looking for a tanto. Can't recommend that enough. It's been one of my favorites for a very long time. I think I've owned it over a year, maybe a good bit over a year. What we've got there is the standard CQC 7. It's got serrations. It's 3.3 inch. Not a bad knife, especially if you just need a rough and tumble work knife. And this is a mini CQC 7, unserrated version, black blade. Not bad. I used it as an EDC for a while for work. Just ended up not wanting the tanto so much. What we've got here is a standard Commander 3.75 inch blade. Really nice knife. Very large in the pocket though. Really wide this way. Still one of my favorites. I just don't carry it that much because of its size. This is a mini Commander. You lose a quarter of an inch in blade length, but you get back a huge amount of pocket space because of that. So I definitely like this knife. This was my EDC for a good long time. In the last 2 3 months, maybe, I can't remember exactly when this came out, but I bought one of these Emerson Micro Commanders, and it immediately jumped up to become my everyday carry knife. It's a 3-inch Emerson Commander version. It's got a thumb hole, sort of like a Strider hole a little bit, instead of the normal thumb disc you see on other Emersons. And it works great as an EDC, in my opinion. It's not that heavy, it's the right size, and I love the blade shape, like all the Emerson Commanders. Great little knife. What we've got here is the full-size CQC 15. It's kind of a combination of a Commander and a Tanto, a little bit. Maybe I like that Roadhouse. Certainly an interesting blade shape, very large. If I didn't already own the Commander and the Roadhouse, I'd probably like this a lot. I actually do like it. I just tend not to carry it, but again, because of that size. And over here, we've got one of my favorite Emersons, along with that Micro Commander. That's this mini CQC 15. It's a 3.5 inch blade. Makes a great everyday carry, in my opinion, if you want an Emerson, a nice knife. It's not nearly as wide as those Commanders, so it fits much better in the pocket. It's got a great blade shape, kind of that Emerson Commander sweep on it. But yet you got that nice pointy tip to punch holes in walls or anything you might need as a hardy work knife. So I really like it. One of my favorites. Down at the bottom, we've got the Karambits, however you want to pronounce it. We've got the Super version, which is 3.2 inch, I believe, and the Combat Karambit, which is 2.6, I think. And I carry this all the time. It goes into my left pocket 4 or even 5 days a week. Anytime I'm wearing jeans or a heavy canvas style docker, that will be in my left pocket as my defensive knife. And either this or this, the mini CQC 15 or the Micro Commander, will be in my right pocket as my EDC. And here are the Strider knives from the collection. I've got three Stealth models, I guess I mostly hear them called. They are black Lego style squared off G10 handled Striders with a spear point style blade and black oxide. I really like this style. It's very sinister looking, very utilitarian as well. My favorite Strider right there. If I had just these three, I'd be happy. But I didn't let that be. I went out and I bought this one, which is a CC model. And it's got Stonewash on one side and Green Ranger G10 on the other. And it's not a bad knife, but it's just not what I wanted. I definitely prefer the rough texturing of this. I like the black oxide blade, and I like the flame anodizing or whatever they do to the back of some of these too. It looks really neat. The Stonewash, too slippery. Do not care for it as much. Don't like the curves here either. So one of these days I'll trade this away for something I want. Maybe a nice Chris Reeve, Num Zahn or something. Those are the Striders. And these are a more recent collecting frenzy that I've gotten into, and it's Paul knives. This is a collection of both Benchmades and Lone Wolves. And I'll run through the models real quickly here. But I believe Gerber made some Paul knives as well. I'm going to try to pick one up off eBay just to check it out. But my favorites are definitely the Lone Wolf versions. And I'll go through these real quick, though. This is the Defender version of the Paul knives. Benchmade gave them a different name. Benchmade uses numbers rather than the old names that Lone Wolf was using. I definitely prefer the name. I think this might be 230 in Benchmade speak. But the Paul knives are interesting. If you've never seen one, I'll run through how they work real quickly. But the lock is very interesting. On one side of the pivot point, you'll have a disc that's knurled somehow. And on the Benchmades, they just kind of cut slots out of it. And on the Lone Wolf versions, they've got little tiny serrations on them that you probably can't even see in the camera. It looks almost like just a little divot in the center there. But they work the same way, basically. You use your thumb to stick onto that disc, and it's going to lock that blade in place. The disc is kind of connected to the blade itself. And then on the other side, you've got a button. And so when you press in on that button, while your thumb is locking the blade in place, you can move the handle itself. So very unlike other blades, you're not mother folding knives, you're not moving the blade itself, you're moving the handle. And it's a very kind of elegant way to do things, and I like it a lot. And another great feature, I think, of it is that it actually locks them in the closed position. That is not going to open on accident, guaranteed. Unless you break the knife, it is not going to open. To open it, you've got to push that lock in, and then it's going to drop open. And then you can lock it open. You can hear it's very solid sounding as it locks open or closed. You heard the lock open, and then I'll lock it closed. Same noise. Very cool, though. 4-inch Defender, 3.25 or 3.5, I can't recall which, Prankster version. It's Kokobala, I believe, handles on those. This is a Lone Wolf version, the Paul Pocket, I believe is what it's called. I like the, I probably already mentioned that, but I like the Lone Wolf version of the lock better here, the little knurling on there. And I just think they're nicer, the Lone Wolves. They feel nicer. These are the Executive models. The Executive is a neat little, like, 2.6-inch blade on it. These are a couple of Benchmades, a carbon fiber version and a G10 version, and a ivory micarta version. And this is the Lone Wolf again. You can tell by looking at the disc. And again, looking at the Benchmade disc, it's completely different. The Benchmade disc probably works better if your hands are oily or slick, though. This is a Paul Presto. It's an interesting one. It's the only one I've got, and I love the blade shape on it. It's very Emerson Commander-like. I just do not like the ivory micarta anymore. When I first started buying these, I thought it would be great. And in actual use, I do not like it. Carrying them in your pocket, the actual ivory micarta stuff is just kind of a basically plastic. And it chips. And I would carry this one and this one in my pocket with my keys. And they got little chips all over them now. Thankfully, it doesn't discolor or there's no other color beneath it. It's just the same color. But it's no longer smooth. It's actually a little rough feeling now. So, no, again, not my favorite. But the carbon fiber looks very nice. This is the, what is it, the Presto? Yeah, no, I'm sorry, Perfecto. The Perfecto with a worn cliff style blade. Very wicked looking knife. That is the Paul knives from my collection. And we've got 3-inch Benchmade knives. We've got a couple of Benchmade mini griptilians. One's a Tanto with serrations, the other's standard. The yellow one I really like. I use it for travel a lot. It's very friendly looking, cheerful yellow, not scary. And we've got 2707 sequels. One of them serrated, both have black blades. And a Nitrous Striker. The Nitrous Striker is a really neat knife from Benchmade. I wish it had a couple of changes. I wish the pocket clip could be moved so that it was tip-up carry. If they had done that, I'd probably still be carrying this a lot. It's my favorite Benchmade maybe now at this point. Certainly very high. It's the only one I generally will reach into the drawer and grab and use. I'll carry it in my back pocket a lot. Pretty nice knife. I want to get a full-size one. And then we've got the Emissary, 470, I believe it was. This one came out a while back. It's an assisted one, like this Nitrous Striker. A lot lighter. It's an aluminum handle. It takes scars. Shiny pocket clip, which I'm not crazy about. And the Axis Lock, which I am not that crazy about anymore. I've had some trouble with two of the knives that I got rid of with that Axis Lock. And we've got a Barrage. It looks like, yeah, 585, the Mini Barrage. It's a 3-inch assisted opener. It's pretty thick. Very nice knife, though. Not bad. And then a Warren version. Warren, W-A-R-N, like the winch company. It's a Tanto version of the Barrage, basically, with much heavier G10 style scales, I think. I swapped the pocket clip on this one. Down here at the end, I threw this into the Benchmade pile. It's actually a Bradley cutlery, I think it is. Alias 2, maybe? Benchmade's over 3 inches in length. Gotta move quicker, this is taking too long. We've got LFTI Bob Lum models, 760, I believe. Great knives, love the feel, the look, the materials. It's almost art. Very artistic, it's just gorgeous. Some of my most beautiful knives. If I could find a display case for them, I would. I'd put them in there. I'm not going to get rid of them, even though they've got some issues for actual usage, at least everyday carry use. They fall right out of my pocket. The pocket clips don't work on them. And they've got some blade retention issues. When they fall out of your pocket, they invariably end up wide open because of it. But the 705 is this one right here. It's not a bad knife. Not one of my favorites. Deja Vu, it's like a 4-inch, very interesting knife. Bob Lum also, I believe. Same guy as these designers. And I really like it. He's got some great designs. This is, again, is one of my favorites. It's up there with these. I love the looks of this one in particular with the gold ring around the pivot point there. Just a gorgeous knife, all blacked out like that. It's got a tip-down carry. Not one of my favorites. Completely different design than these, but just as gorgeous. The guy's a genius with beauty. Here's a non-black version of the same knife. 4-inch Deja Vu. And here's a mini Deja Vu. I think it's like a 3.4-inch or 3.2, I forget. Great little knife. They're a little thick. But if you got room in your pocket, great everyday carry knife. I carried this one for a good while. Very smooth. Easy to flip open like a Spyderco. Great knives. And then the Harley-Davidson Back Road. I've talked about this in other videos. It's a great knife. I actually like it a lot. Love the size and the weight. It's very lightweight for its size. Love that blade shape. Great shape on it. The only thing I don't really like are the fact that it's a Harley-Davidson knife. It's got the logo on it and the writing on it there. I'd much rather just be a normal Benchmade. And then it's got little pistons for the thumb studs and the axis lock there. I'd prefer it just be normal. It also came with a different pocket clip that I swapped out. I didn't care for it that much. I put on the normal split arrow from Benchmade. Very nice EDC knife, though, if they just make some fixes to it, make it a normal Benchmade rather than a Harley-Davidson. And here's a Warren version of the full-size Barrage. I think it's a 587, maybe. I'm sorry, no, 583, I think. But it's assisted opening Tanto. Real heavy compared to the normal Barrage. And even though I still like Spyderco, especially the American-made ones, my collection of Spydercos has really shrunk a good bit. All I've got left are a couple of militaries, a titanium and then a black, and then a special pink Mannix. My orange knives have a special drawer just for themselves, and there's a couple of Spydercos actually hiding in there as well. We've got an orange Spyderco military and a full-size Benchmade Griptilian. I think it's the H2O version with the serrations. And we've got my last two CRKTs, I believe. It's the M16, 13, and 12 ZER. That's the kind of the spear point or dagger point. And then this is the Tanto. And we've got a little Kershaw that come in orange. It's a little Tanto with serrations. I think that's a Zing. And then the little Spyderco. It's like a Rescue UK PK, maybe? Something like that. And here's some more odds and ends that are American-made. We've got $2, a Buck Vantage Pro full-size, and then the smaller version. Really nice knives. Love the Vantage Pro. Love the flow-through design on them. I've got two good ones. Other people reported some issues. Blade alignment's pretty good on both of them. It doesn't drag on either side. And really nice. Nice and easy to open. A little heavy. G10, I guess, adds a good bit of weight. Thick liners, maybe, or something. But very nice. And we've got a Kershaw Skyline, I believe it is. And this one's the Damascus blade. So pretty fancy looking. Pretty neat for a $30 knife. The pocket clip was gray, and one day I got the bright idea to throw some paint on it. And it's actually stuck pretty well. And then we've got a zero tolerance. I think this is the 350. Not a bad knife. Pretty big and heavy and wide. just prefer other stuff. And here are some odds and ends from the collection. We've got a camp knife from Imperial, I believe. It's called the Camp King with a K. K for camp. And we've got a Canal Street Whittler and a Case Whittler. These are nice little three-blade knives. I like those. And this is another Canal Street. It's a, they call this a Knittler, I believe. It's a combination of a, like a canoe and a Whittler. We've got a little Benchmade 470 Shoki, I believe. Little itty-bitty gentleman's knife. Very thin. Uses a weird knack lock. You push in a little button there. I like the knife. I like the color and the shape and everything, but I just don't like that lock style. And we've got a little itty-bitty Benchmade here that I bought when I went to Chicago a year or so ago. I don't even remember its name, but it was legal to carry there, so I bought it. Not a bad little knife. A little assisted opener. Huge Canal Street knife. Hunter model, I think. Trapper, something like that. Bunch of Swiss Army style knives. We've got a Winger and then a Victorinox. Another Victorinox. Two more, actually. And these are the Soldier models, and I think that's a Pioneer. And what's that, like, I don't know, a Waiter? Tinker, something like that. And then we've got the new Soldier model. I've got a rescue knife, a couple of them, actually, one for each car. They look like this, except they're black or yellow. And the rescue knives have a windshield shatter or something on it as well. And the dregs of the collection. These are the stuff that you don't put into drawers, don't take care of. They just throw up in piles. In this box, we've got various Bokers, which I actually still tend to leave in my desk drawer at work. I've got a number of those besides what you see here. The Hyper model is the one I like. They're only like 30 bucks, so I've got a bunch of them. I tend to lose them at work. And then we've got a bigger one here, and I don't even remember the name of this one. But it's a good bit bigger and heavier. Not bad. And some other Bokers. Lots of Bokers. Boker ceramics. Some old ancient slippets, or whatever you want to call them. Like Stockman's, and then what is this? Like a big old buck. And over in this box, we've got the garbage. The stuff that you just end up with because people give you them, or they hear you like knives, and they bring in some junk that they found. They're fun to look at and play with, but there's nothing of any value there. And that's it. That is my collection, December 22nd, 2011.